Captain? Captain?
Captain.
Sorry, you were asking about the Scarborough.
I was. Specifically, how the hell did she find you out there?
A trap laid by your father, for which he will be answering as soon as I'm finished here.
He won't be the only one, I assume. Your friend, Mrs. Barlow, understood she was responsible for keeping him under lock and key. You trusted her. We trusted her, and she betrayed us.
Perhaps he managed to secrete a message past her men. That hardly rises to the level of betrayal.
Captain, yesterday morning, my father walked into town, stood out on the steps of the warehouse and proclaimed to the world that the Guthrie's business is finished here in NASA.
What was the reaction?
The men elected representatives. We agreed upon an agenda. And we spoke about the merits of mutual cooperation over tea.
So it was bad?
Bad? It was fucking chaos.
Yeah.
For about an hour, I thought they'd burn down all of NASA. But it's been handled. As of last night, I've instituted a new trading system, and the street has embraced it. A consortium with myself at its head, Captains Naft and Lawrence as a means of shipping, and Mr. Fraser as its corporate seal.
Huh. All this since yesterday. I will address the situation with Mrs. Barlow immediately. You have my word.
Captain, one more thing. The consortium wasn't founded easily. It required the assistance of a few other parties. Among them, indispensably, was Mr. Silver.
Is that so?
I tell you this because I imagine you might still hold some resentment toward him. And I've given him my word in exchange for his assistance that I'll stand between him and your resentment. In other words, if Mr. Silver doesn't return from the Urca, you and I may find ourselves with problems of our own.
What a day I missed. Come on.